Welcome in for a little happy hour. My good friend Derek from Glazers is in. What are we making today, sir?
Well, we're going to try three products. Mm-hmm. We're going to do two Madeiras, and then we're going to do a South African vermouth, and then we're going to mix a vermouth and one of the Madeiras together and call it a madcap.
Okay.
So these are really oddball. There's no one in town that's doing this, and you can't even find these in town right now. That's how kind of oddball-y they
are. Can I ask you what a Madeira is?
Sure. A Madeira, it falls in the fortified wine category.
So similar to a...
It's like a port and a sherry.
Got it.
But the distinction between ports and sherries and Madeira is that Madeira is heated.
Oh, like you serve? No, it's just when it's made, it's
when
heated.
When it's made, it's heated, which you don't want to do that to any other wine because it ruins it.
Interesting.
But in the process of making this, it's heated, and that allows it to last hundreds of years. If you open this bottle, which it's already open, mm-hmm. but if you open that and you wanted to serve it 100 years from now when we're not around,
are you
it'll
it's still
going to be good.
Oh, that's so interesting.
You could leave it out on Polk Street in the heat, leave it on your roof. Serve it
all as well
because it's been heated, so you can't do any more damage to it because it's fortified.
Interesting.
It's the perfect cocktail.
Okay.
It's the perfect drink because you can't ruin it. It lasts forever.
That's so interesting.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Now, so people probably, I mean, I've never heard of it. People are probably not terribly familiar with it, right?
No, they're not, because they think it's a port or a sherry, which port and sherries are fortified, but once you open them, they'll only last for a few days or a month maybe at best. And this is the most equivalent to like a tawny port.
Okay.
Most people will familiarize themselves with that because uh-huh. it's that nutty, caramelized because of the heat.
Got it.
And
all
there's
right.
two
that
ways
makes sense.
You can do it. There's a synthetic way and then there's a natural way.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to taste both.
All right. Well, let's give it a shot. Let's
sure.
give it a taste.
This is rainwater, and this is done the synthetic way.
Mm-hmm.
This is done in a foudre, which is a heated jacket. So what they do...
It's an interesting color, too, isn't it?
It is. It's kind of light, it's really light, yellow, pale, but when you try this one, that's going to be more brown. But a foudre, what they do is they put a heating jacket around the vessel
mm-hmm.
that they make it in,
mm-hmm.
up to 3 months, and it heats it to about 150 degrees.
It's very sweet. That's got a very cool flavor to it, though.
It's really cool, and this is kind of a generic version of Madeira, and they have four noble mm-hmm. varieties of Madeira, and this is the upper end, because you have Sercial, then you have Verdelho, mm-hmm. you have Boal, and then you have Malmsey. Those are the four. And
I was looking those up.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get to the cocktail real fast. We got about
sure.
30 seconds left.
Okay. The cocktail, this is the only vermouth that comes out of South Africa.
Uh-huh.
And it's made from Chenin Blanc.
Uh-huh.
Then they distill Chenin Blanc, and then they add 35 different botanicals to it. They actually add over 1,000, but they only register 35 of them.
Oh, wow.
And so it's really, really distinct. But the cool thing right now going across the country, hadn't hit so much here, is that people are substituting their syrups.
Yes.
For this. They're using this instead of vermouth in their Sazeracs or their old fashions
Very
or Manhattans.
Cool.
They're
Very
using
cool.
this. And they're also using this too.
Very nice. Hey, we learned a lot today. We're going to show you the finished cocktail over on our Facebook page, so check it out. Thanks for being with us today. Good happy hour.